สวัสดีค่ะ Experiment number 6 on heat of reaction ค่ะ The objectives of this experiment are shown here. 1. To measure enthalpy of a chemical reaction using a simple calorimeter. Number 2. To prove Hess's law concept. The introduction. As we learned that chemical reaction in general involve with heat, and the heat evolved with chemical reaction at constant pressure is called an enthalpy. And there are two ways of heat which involve in chemical reaction. One is for exothermic reaction, and we will get delta H as a negative value. And another is the endothermic reaction, we get delta H in a positive value. The change of enthalpy is a state function, which means it depends only on the final and the initial condition. Enthalpy change doesn't depend on how the reaction proceeds, and this is the Hess's law concept. In Hess's law concept, it said that the heat involved in a chemical process is the same whether a process takes place in one step or in several steps. In this experiment, we are trying to answer the question, what is the heat of reaction between hydrochloric solution and sodium hydroxide in a solid form? And the chemical reaction between the two is shown here. Sodium hydroxide in a solid form in reaction with hydrochloric acid solution, and the product would be water and salt sodium chloride. And not only we will get the value of heat of reaction, we are trying to prove that Hess's law concept can be applied. We're gonna have to do the experiment to prove this Hess's law concept. The reaction that I said earlier can be occur in two steps. Step number one, we get sodium hydroxide in a solid form dissolved in water first, and that will generate cation and anion. The heat involved in this reaction would be delta H1. And the second step would be the sodium hydroxide, which is now in a solution, react with solution of hydrochloric acid, and that would give you the product water and sodium chloride salt. The heat that involved in this reaction is delta H2. If I change the form of this sodium hydroxide slightly to be like this, we see that sodium ion and hydroxide ion can then be cancelled with the first reaction, and that makes the summation of these two reactions as in the final reaction shown here. And from the concept of enthalpy change, we get that the summation of the two reactions give the final reaction. The enthalpy change is a result of the delta H1 plus delta H2 as shown here. This reaction of interest can also occur in just one step, like this. You see, it look the one step reaction looks exactly the same as in the summation of reaction in two steps. So for the Hess's law, delta H1 plus delta H2 must equal to delta H3 because this equation looks exactly the same as this equation. So back to our question, we are going to find what is the heat of reaction between hydrochloric solution and sodium hydroxide solid, and at the same time we're going to prove Hess's law. So we are going to do experiment to find delta H1, delta H2, and delta H3 using the calorimeter. Look at the calorimeter. It is a device used to measure the heat release or heat absorbed by the physical or chemical process. Using the first law of thermodynamics, which states that heat transfer between system and surrounding. If the heat is lost from the system, it must be gained by the surrounding. So we can create the mathematics relationship between heat of system and heat of surrounding like this. The quantity of the heat must be the same, only the direction of change would be the opposite. So in our reaction of interest, the reaction will occur and heat generated in the reaction would be transferred to its surrounding solution. So we can make Q of reaction equal to the negative sign or the opposite direction change of heat of solution. And we change this heat in the form of enthalpy change of reaction and calculate the amount of heat using mass, specific heat, and different in temperature of solution. Remember, we learned from the lecture that delta T used in this calculation must be calculated from the final temperature minus initial temperature. However, the calorimeter in the laboratory is not perfect. The perfect calorimeter must be a very good insulator, which means it will not take any heat from reaction or try to transfer heat from itself to the reaction. Unfortunately, the calorimeter in our laboratory is a very simple one, so the calorimeter itself will take some of the heat. So we have to change this relationship slightly. Rather than the heat from reaction goes to the surrounding solution entirely or completely, some of it will be transferred to the calorimeter itself. Therefore, we have to calculate what is the heat capacity of our calorimeter in the laboratory also. Whatever heat generated from the reaction will be transferred to the surrounding solution, which is inside of the calorimeter. Okay, m here, small m, is the mass of the surrounding solution. C here is specific heat of water, because the solution that we use in our lab experiment has water as the solvent. So we're gonna use the specific heat of water. Delta T is the difference in temperature, the final temperature minus initial temperature. Capital C is the heat capacity of calorimeter itself. We are not trying to get the specific heat, so we don't care about the mass of the calorimeter. Difference of temperature would be the same because the calorimeter contains this solution, so the difference in temperature will be the same. So we're going to use this relationship in our calculation. So the experiment procedure has been designed to be two parts. Part number one, as I said, we're going to determine the heat capacity of the calorimeter. Number two, then we will determine the heat of reaction, delta H1, delta H2, and delta H3, as shown here. Let's see the chemicals and equipment used for this experiment. We're gonna need calorimeter with stirrer and thermometer to record the temperature change, and some basic laboratory glassware. We're gonna need solid sodium hydroxide, look like this, and then we need two solution, sodium hydroxide 1 molar solution and hydrochloric acid also 1 molar. Let's start part number one. determination of heat capacity of calorimeter. So we are going to do experiment to see how the heat is transferred between the hot water. We're gonna heat some water up using the hot plate. Heat it until the temperature is over 60 degrees Celsius and some room temperature water. First, we're gonna add 25 milliliters of water into the beaker, which is now in the calorimeter, and then record the temperature of this room temperature water. And the result is record that the temperature here is 31.2 degrees Celsius. So the mass of this water would be 25 gram using density of water equal to 1 gram per milliliter. Number two, we add 25 milliliter of warm water that we already heated into a separate cylinder, 25 milliliter, and measure the temperature of this hot water and record as T2 just before adding this water into the calorimeter. So the temperature is still going up. Okay, when it's done, pour this hot water into the same calorimeter that already has the room temp water in it. So the record T2 temperature is 57.9 degrees Celsius. M2, the amount of water, is 25 milliliter or so. So mass is 25 gram. And then we mix the warm water and room temp water together using the stirrer. Mix the, and you see that the temperature of the room temp water that was about 31 degrees Celsius is now increased. And you would record the final temp as TF, and the final temp is 42 degrees Celsius. So now heat is transferred between the warm water and the room temp water, which is inside the calorimeter. So the amount of heat here, which is calculated from mass specific heat, delta T, or change in temperature, has a negative sign. It's released. This amount of heat is transferred to the room temp water and calorimeter. So calculate from mass of this room temp water, specific heat of water and temperature change, plus heat capacity of calorimeter and temperature change. You see that this has a negative sign and this has a positive sign. Okay. Don't forget to use final temp minus initial temp. Warm water has initial temp as T2, and that is 57.9 degrees Celsius. M2, the mass of warm water, is 25 gram. M1, the mass of room temp water, 25 gram. T1, initial temp of the room temp water inside calorimeter, T1 is the same, 31.2 degrees Celsius. When the warm water release heat to room temp water and calorimeter, the temperature is decreased to be final temp. When room temp water and calorimeter absorb heat, the final temperature is increased as TF, and the or Tf are the same as 42 degrees Celsius. The small c use value of 4.184 joule per degree Celsius per gram. Do the calculation and show details of calculation in your report. Find out what is the value of heat capacity of the calorimeter. And we're gonna continue using this C in calculation of heat of reaction in part 2.